Charlie 8-1, contact, wake out.
Delta 4-3, roger, over.
Charlie 4-7, proceed with your sit rep, over.
Charlie 4-7, thank you, Zero. We are on the southern slopes of the Ice Mountain. Greet Delta Uniform 573.
Hello, Zero, this is Charlie 8-1. We have incoming artillery and small arms. Request air support, over.
We are under constant fire from snipers. At least two flip-flops up there.
Hello, Zero, this is Charlie 8-1. We have incoming artillery and small arms fire. Request air support.
We have made contact with our RPGs and GPs, but are unable to move forward without close air.
Hello, Zero, this is Charlie 8-1. We have incoming artillery and small arms. Request air support. Hello, Zero, this is Charlie 8-1. Radio check, please. Radio check, please.
Charlie 8-1, this is Zero. Sorry we lost you there. Sit rep, please. Over.
This is Charlie 8-1. We are under heavy artillery fire from a range of approximately 6 kilometers, maybe 10. Request air support ASAP. They have an ISTAR asset overhead in the sky and artillery and are engaging with 14.5s. We're sitting ducks here. We have now suffered a direct hit on our forward position. 3 dead. Not 4. I can't see with the mist and the blood. The shells are continuous. Our commanding officer is... He's down. He's gone. Request air support. Over.
Charlie 8-1, we have 2 A-10s in transit. ETA 6 minutes. Hang in there.
This is Charlie 8-1. I've been hit. We've got missiles and mortars falling on us like rain. My entire platoon has been obliterated. I'm dead. Repeat, I'm dead. Damn it. Damn it all. I hate being dead.
Red and Blue by Philip Palmer. Hearts and Minds.
Name?
Emma McIntosh, operational analyst attached to MOD.
I'll tell the Colonel you're waiting.
Colonel Bradley Shoreham, the man who nearly started a war between Britain and its NATO ally Turkey.
Thank you.
Operation Scarlet Mountains wasn't my first war game exercise, but it was the largest I'd ever been involved in. A truly massive affair. They had 3 aircraft hangars in an army base in the south of England, dedicated to a simulated war in various imaginary countries. 6,000 British personnel were in place, hooked up by radio to hundreds of other Rapid Response Corps soldiers at their bases in America, Spain, and Germany. We were fighting the Reds, an imaginary people invented by Bradley Shoreham, the author and creator of this entire fictional war.
Good luck, Mr. O'Donnell.
Thank you. I don't know what to expect.
Well, I'd like to say just be yourself, but that would defeat the object somewhat.
That would.
You despise us, don't you?
What?
The British Army, officer class, people like me.
No, I don't.
Working class boy made good, dirt under the fingernails, metaphorically. Despite all you've achieved, you've still got a chip on your shoulder.
No, I haven't.
No? I stand corrected. I thought you were just another chippy paddy, despite your M.A. Oxen.
Oh, you're wrong on all counts. I'm not chippy. I reject the word paddy, and I don't believe in honorary M.A.'s.
Ah, now who's been the snob? I suppose you've got relatives who are still proud of being ex-IRA. I bet they'll sing their rebel songs of a Saturday night.
I'm a Protestant. Did you read your briefing papers?
You're all paddies in my book. My answer to the Irish troubles, sail the whole bloody island out into the Atlantic and pull the plug.
Now, don't you read the newspapers either? We have peace now.
We have peace now, sir.
What?
Call me sir. For the purposes of this exercise, military discipline applies. You will call me sir and you will salute.
Sir!
At ease.
Sir, yes, sir!
This is our wind-up, I assume.
What?
A part of the role play? Pretending to be an old Etonian git to get me into the right frame of mind so I can demonstrate sufficient surly chippiness in playing my role in this war game exercise.
That will be a highly manipulative thing to do.
Or maybe you are just a git.
Mm. Enjoy your prison cell, Mr. Red.
Don't call me that. It's risible.
For the purposes of this exercise, you are Mr. Red. You evil, murdering terrorist scum.
Now for the purposes of this exercise, and taking into account that Mr. Red has a black belt in Aikido...
My bad arm.
Just kidding.
For the purposes of the exercise, this prisoner has just assaulted me.
On the ground! On the ground!
Don't be so... Stop that. Is that gun loaded?
For the purpose of the exercise, open fire.
Bang!
And now I'm dead. Hey, you're gonna lose this war.
You'll do.
Is Mr. Shoreham ready for me yet?
Colonel Shoreham has just left the building. He's on his way to XCOM, then to Blue Forces in Aircraft Hangar 1, then back within the hour 2 at most. I have a message for you. Tell OA, please wait.
Everyone had a role to play, except for XCOM, Exercise Control, who were the umpires. Red's team were the enemy. In reality, a bunch of British soldiers playing merry hell with their fellow officers. Blue team were the training audience, a.k.a. the Allied armies, including the Brits. And we all took it very seriously. Even me, the numbers wonk. It's my job to count how many bullets get fired and how fast, and how many people die on either side, and turn it into graphs and ratios. Even death can be a ratio.
Going well, sir.
The exercise director was General Gibbs, chief umpire of this shooting match. I never met him, but I saw him from a distance. One of those lean, scarily fit older men. Bradley called him the Whippet.
What?
Going well?
I wouldn't say so. It's a bloody shambles. Blue forces are being thrashed in every contact. I may have to intervene. Maybe take command of a few platoons.
Sir, I'm not sure that's appropriate for you to... Well.
Yes, Bradley.
Nothing, sir.
I know I can't intervene. It doesn't mean I have to damn well like it.
And the war that was going so badly was being fought on many fronts. With planes, tanks, guns, and words.
So, what happens now?
I interrogate you. Let me get myself sorted first. Very good. My name is Hargreaves, British Intelligence. I've been sent to talk to you.
Hello, Mr. Hargreaves. I am Mr. Red.
Take it seriously, please, Mr. O'Donnell.
Who the hell is O'Donnell? I am Mr. Red.
The Reds have no country of their own. They are an ethnic minority with soldiers and a grievance. Some call them terrorists. And Mr. Red was once their leader until he was captured and sent to jail. His followers are now attempting to conquer territory that will become their homeland. And the Blues, who take a dim view of terrorists waging war, have assembled a formidable fighting force to defeat the Reds, commanded from his desk in Aircraft Hangar 1 by Brigadier Harper.
The storm is here, sir.
I'm aware of that. I can read a computer screen as well as you can.
Your troops are badly exposed.
They'll dig in. They're a hardy lot.
You might have been better advised to wait 24 hours before launching your assault.
With the wisdom of hindsight, all things are easy.
There was a weather warning.
I made a judgment call.
Very good, sir. Have you read the casualty list, sir?
203 soldiers dead, 300 more injured and casualty.
The worst British fatalities in a single contact since the Second World War.
And that doesn't trouble you? They have the high ground. We're proceeding through the Greenland territory, which is thick with ethnic Reds. Our intelligence services dismally failed to warn us that the Reds in the Scarlet Mountains are equipped with unmanned drones and state-of-the-art missile systems, including an entire batch of Hellfire missiles. We were told we were fighting a bunch of mountain-dwelling guerrilla terrorists with AK-47s, and instead, we're up against a modern army. Despite that, we've inserted two companies into the target area and bombed the devil out of their command and control center. We're doing all right.
You are.
By the way, the casualty list I was sent had names on it. It's normally just numbers, but you've got actual names.
One of my little tricks, call it a foible.
Garrett, Rayner, Cullen. Are these the names of real British soldiers? I'm not sure I'm enthusiastic about your foible, Bradley. This gave me a nasty turn.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.